Hey everybody, Kevin at Woodcraft here, and today we're going to be putting together a downdraft table using the downdraft panel kit from WoodRiver. I went up to my Woodcraft store, got the downdraft panel kit, a sheet of our half inch Baltic birch plywood, and a 4-inch flanged inlet. Now I chose a 4-inch inlet because we already have a bunch of 4-inch hoses around the shop, but be sure to choose the appropriate size for your dust collection system. First, we're going to head over to the table saw and cut 2 6-inch strips off the plywood. I chose 6 inches tall because of our 4-inch inlet, but if you're using one of these smaller inlets, you could definitely make it shorter if you wanted to. Next, we're gonna stack up those two pieces, take it over the chop saw, and we're gonna cut the long sides, the short sides, and 2 extra pieces that will come into play later. Onto the router table to rabbet the sides for the bottom. Back to the table saw, we're going to cut an extra inch or so off of those 2 extra pieces that I talked about, and you'll see why in a little bit. We're going to measure the dimensions of our sides after we put them together and cut a bottom for it. Now, because of the dimensions of this piece, I didn't feel comfortable doing it on the table saw, so I took it over the chop saw, made one cut, and then flipped it around and finished the cut. And then since we were already here, I just decided to make the other cut this way as well. Next, we're going to mark center on one of the long sides so we know where to position the inlet. I'll drill a little entry hole and then cut it out on the scroll saw because it is a 4-inch hole and I don't have a 4-inch Forstner bit, obviously. This doesn't have to be super precise, so I've just got a high tooth count blade, and it cuts out no problem. Then we'll pre-drill and screw the plastic inlet to the side, and it looks real nice. Then we're going to toss our scrap in the trash can and make it, so we'll celebrate. Now we'll put down some glue and assemble the box. I'm using Tight-Bond Quick and Thick because I'd like to get this done before the end of the day. May have put a little too much on this piece, but that's okay. I'll tell you what, I absolutely love this Bessie strap clamp. It is perfect for boxes and drawers and things like that. And use a couple pin nails to hold it all together while it dries. Now those extra pieces are going to get glued and attached to the inside of your short side pieces. And that is what the downdraft panels are actually going to sit on. So they need to be about 3/4 of an inch shorter than your side pieces.
If you haven't seen these before, it comes with 2 of these little panels. Okay. It has got rubber grommets on the top, so your piece won't slide around. You got 4 of these bench dogs that you can put wherever you want to register your work against. And it's got another piece to cut off half of your system if you're working on a smaller piece.
The only other thing I would recommend that I forgot to do for this video, as you can see, is add some non-skid feet to the bottom. That will help it from moving around and hold everything nice and steady.
This is a super simple afternoon project that can really help keep the dust down in your shop. To pick up one of these downdraft kits or anything else for your woodworking needs, head over to your local Woodcraft store or online to woodcraft.com.